Now, for finding radical functions, really what is most important to me is that people just understand generally how to plug in things for functions. So you'll just have a couple of problems, where you'll kind of play with that. So I'll give you, say, f of x minus 4, and say, okay, can you find f of 8? Or can you find f of 3? Or say f of 6? Now, you should remember from other, I guess, algebra work, like if I have this, and if I want to find f of 1, it literally means everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 1. Right? If I want to find f of negative 6, literally means everywhere I see an x, I put a negative 6. Or something like that. Okay? Good? Okay. So if that's familiar, you're in good shape. If that's not familiar, you need to go review how to use functions. But we're going to use the same kind of theory. Okay, so it's the same, except now when you have a radical, you just have to deal with a radical. So everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put in 8. So 8 minus 4. So square root of 4 is 2. Good to go. These really aren't that bad. Square root of everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 6. So 6 minus 4, square root of 2. None so bad. Let me give you another one to play with. These really can't get too exciting. Just kind of a plug and chug problem. So let me give you. All right, so here are some problems to play with. Try to go work them out, come back, see if you got them right. All right, so literally everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 0. Where I see an x, I'm going to put a 0. So, cube root of 2. That's about all you can do. It's beautiful, isn't it? Everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a 6. Cube root of 8 is 2. Everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a minus 29. Cube root of negative 27 is negative 3. And everywhere I see an x, I'm going to put a negative 1. And the cube root of 1 is 1. And I think that's plenty of rational and, sorry, radical expressions for the moment. Thank you very much. Enjoy.